Hi, this is Dave Yoder with Danfoss Tech Support, and in today's video, we're going to look at making a calculation for a compressor minimum runtime. So in northern climates, you may run into a situation where a compressor does not run very often at all, and sometimes that can cause problems with oil on the parallel compressor rack. So in this video, we're going to look at a way to use a calculation to force a minimum runtime on a compressor. So I've already set up in the compressor relay, a dummy relay actually, to serve as the relay for the compressor. So we can see when it's actually turning on and off. And then we'll use a calculation to force it to run once a day for 10 minutes. So we're gonna go into configuration and control, and then go into miscellaneous and calculations. So we can build this calculation. Obviously, we don't have any calculations listed here yet, so we're going to pick calculation number one. This is our calculation. We'll go double click it to edit it. It's going to be an on-off calculation, so OI is fine and generic is fine. Let's give it a name. My compressor I'm working on is compressor A5, so we'll give it a name. And then the calculation already assigns a relay to start with, and that works for us. So we're gonna select the dummy relay that I've already assigned under the rack for that compressor. So we've got our relay. Now we need to tell it when to run. So we're gonna add a schedule. We've got an empty data point here, so we'll double click on that. Scroll down until we get to the schedule option. Now we've got a 24/7 schedule, but we need to edit that. I'll double click on that. We're going to change this to run, let's say, at 7 a.m. to start. And we're going to let it run for 10 minutes. So we will have the schedule from 7 to 7:10, and that should work for us. Now we have to back up a step. We'll see the changes in the calculation. And we need to make a couple changes here to finish out the calculation. This line will be changed to be our on option for the compressor. And we're going to tell the calculation we want it to be on if that compressor is running under the rack operation or the schedule happens to be true. And that'll be from 7 till 7:10 in the morning. We're also going to tell it in this screen that if the compressor is not running under the rack and the schedule is not true, that that compressor is allowed to be off. And we back up a screen and you'll see how that works. So obviously at the top, we set some basic options. In the middle, we defined our compressor that we need to look at plus our schedule. And then down here in the bottom, it will read as relay one, which is our compressor, or the schedule can be on. If either one of those is true, this calculation will switch on, and we'll see in a minute that that will turn on the actual compressor relay. So here's our dummy relay. We've set up our calculation. Now let's go look at a miscellaneous relay output where we'll program the actual compressor relay. Switch over to relays. I've set up the name for this miscellaneous relay, the actual board point for the compressor, and now I need to link the calculation we just built with this miscellaneous relay output. Here's our calculation number one. We program that in, and I also set a minimum on time just to be sure that it doesn't short cycle for any reason, but with the schedule, that should be a non-problem for us. Thanks for watching our video. For more information on Danfoss system controllers, please go to danfoss.com/supermarket support.